Thank you. Hey everybody, Sean James here. How you doing? I'm gonna keep working here while I talk. I do have a lav mic on, so hopefully you can hear this okay. That's not hair sticking out of my shirt. That's the mic with a dead cat on it for the wind. So I'm just doing the concrete base here on the kitchen. This specifically is the base for the pizza oven or the bread oven. But while I was doing that, I was thinking how absurd some of this must seem to you and sometimes to me as well. The amount of work I'm putting into the projects that I'm doing here, especially the fact that I'm doing them alone and with all these random materials. Now in some regards, the combination of the modern materials, like all this concrete I'm using, is contradiction to the whole concept, I guess, of my self-reliance, or at least what people think my self-reliance means. So it's kind of making me think more about what I'm doing here, and I actually have learned a lot myself since I started doing this a year and a half ago about why I'm doing it, what's wrong with what I'm doing, what's right about what I'm doing, and what else I've done with the rest of my life and what I'm planning on doing for the rest of my life. So what I was thinking is that the idea of living alone, first of all, is not what my self-reliance is about. It never was. I kind of got sidetracked doing canoe trips and outdoor trips and then working here alone. So it kind of gives the impression that my self-reliance is sort of validating the hermit concept, where you leave society to live a simpler life like this without having to interact with people. And that's really not what this is about. But what my self-reliance does mean to me is just to get your act together, for me to get my act together, for me to be responsible for myself. And right now I'm kind of going through a good period, a period in my life without much chaos, without much conflict. And there's a tendency or the proclivity to become more complacent because of that. So I think part of me doing this cabin, especially at this period, and when I started this cabin in particular last year, it's going through a short period of abundance and lack of chaos, like I said. Just things were going very, very well for me and my family, in contradiction to how we were feeling and how I was doing, say, 6 or 7 years ago when the business failed and I was in that financial debt. When I look at my life, my family's healthy right now, both my kids as well as my sisters and my wife's family and my parents in their mid-70s, but they're still healthy, good shape, and financially secure. If I'm particularly sympathetic or empathetic towards people and kind of the extended family, you know, there's mental illness, there's schizophrenia in the family, there's some undiagnosed mental issues, there's extreme anxiety, social anxiety, fairly close family members that just can't seem to get along with other people and don't have good relationships. They don't have spouses that they can count on, or they don't have spouses at all. And if you've been following the channel since last year when I started doing these talks, that was about a year and a half ago that I started opening up a little bit about more about myself and about my life. And then almost exactly a year ago, standing in pretty well this spot, I talked about men and stepping up and becoming better men. And that was the first time I got lashed back, I guess. I got negative comments, people calling me arrogant and self-centered and judgmental. And it kind of took me by surprise, because that's not the way I am. What I was doing was expressing frustration in the men that my sisters at the time were involved with. And the fact that they were having a hard time and have had a hard time their entire lives finding decent spouses or decent companions. So I was expressing frustration in that. So it looked like I was condemning young men in particular, who I was suggesting need to man up. And I'm not changing my position on that. But what I've done since then, especially through some self-reflection here at the cabin while I'm working, is reflecting on my own insecurities, my own shortcomings. But more than anything, I think I wanted to express the challenges that people have these days, especially the younger generation. My daughters are at that age right now where they're finished high school. They're setting out to post-secondary education. They're looking at career choices, career options. They're looking at places to live. they're at that age where whoever they're dating may end up being their lifelong spouse or companion. So I'm looking at the challenges from their perspective, and I'm realizing that, first of all, as much as it was difficult for me at that age, they have it worse as far as the financial system, the residential housing prices and rent, even things like that. They're very challenging. The fact that my generation coddled that generation, the younger generation, so much so that we protected them from adversity and therefore robbed them of the education that they required to learn the skills in order to become more self-reliant. So my self-reliance is that. It's taking responsibility for your own actions, taking responsibility for your own failures and successes, and then becoming a better person or better capable of taking care of yourself, but also that therefore becoming less of a burden on society and more help to society. So I think that's a great thing. I think that's what we need more than ever in this day and age, whether or not you believe in apocalyptic events potentially setting us back and requiring these skills. So the confidence and the competence that you gain from doing things yourself and being able to take care of yourself go a long way in your ability to interact with the world, with society, with spouses, with family members, and so on. So that is my actual primary message, it's the primary reason I'm doing this. Like I said, the adversity that I'm kind of lacking in my life right now, I created it here. So I've created friction, I've created a more difficult existence by trying to live this simpler life and building this cabin alone, building this kitchen, and then the next projects that I'm about to move on to. All of these things are sort of fictional on one hand and absurd as well when you think about it, because we have this amazing infrastructure, this amazing society that we've created I can't take responsibility for it, that the previous generations and the greater society have created. We live in an amazing time, best time in history to be alive. More opportunity, less strife, less adversity, yet we're not feeling fulfilled. So we want to blame others, we want to blame society, we want to blame governments, and not take responsibility for any of our own happiness, any of our own existence ourselves. So I want to continue to just reflect on that as I'm working around here, but like I said, I want to make the point that this is probably absurd. This lifestyle is kind of ridiculous for most people. It's not something to aspire to, but it is something to maybe learn from. For example, my kids go to university. So I failed high school, as you know. I didn't pass. I was short 4 credits. All of my friends growing up, all the friends that I hung out with, continued on to university, to post-secondary education. I went into the trades because I couldn't finish high school. I couldn't go to post-secondary school. So I was probably looked at as a bit of a failure for that. But the reality is that it taught me skills that are very valuable to not only myself, but to society. So I think we need to remember that people who actually do things, get things done, are extremely valuable members of society, not only to maintain the existing infrastructure, but to continue moving us forward. So I think maybe my main point is that this is kind of a call to action. What I'm doing here is a call to action for each and every one of us to step up, learn the necessary skills to take care of ourselves, whether it's something like this or something completely unrelated, but it's valuable to yourself and to society and to your families. And just focusing on doing things for yourself rather than counting on other people to hand it over to you.